Blackstone Audio presents Westley, A Spider's Tale by Bryan Beus. This book is read by Ramón de Ocampo. To my mother and father. Chapter 1. Near the base of a dead volcano, at the edge of a distant island, stood a small glass menagerie. Clouds passed overhead, lit at the edges by the rising sun. Shielded from the outside elements, the plants, trees, and bushes grew thick and green inside the square building. Sunlight filtered through the domed ceiling and illuminated a chandelier hanging in the center of the room. Brilliant gold and white flowers covered the chandelier and filled the space right up to the edge. As the morning sun rose, light streamed through the high menagerie windows, illuminating both the wide-open mouths of flower cups and the abundant angel ivy covering the chandelier. Waterfalls trickled from leaf pools, and the stream they formed traveled all the way from the top of the chandelier down to its edge and then tumbled out of sight. Exotic flowers grew around the crystals, creating an unorganized but beautiful garden. At the highest level of the chandelier, several young caterpillars splashed in puddles and slid on slippery leaves. Some played under a sprinkler attached to the menagerie's water pipes. An energetic and chubby caterpillar, with a delicate jaw, stood on a ledge in front of a dozen other caterpillars who were watching in anticipation. She held two leaves as if they were wings.
"This is me, in style," crooned Sarah, waving the leaves on her back.
She leaped from her 3-inch perch and landed with a bounce on her fat belly. Another caterpillar, with round cheeks and a double chin, pointed at the bud of an exotic flower and, with a heavy nod, proclaimed, "When I get my wings, the first thing I'm going for is nectar straight from the tap."
"I just want to soak my wings in the sun," said a third, stretching her arms out wide.
They ran together in circles around the garden, leaping on top of each other, singing songs, and swinging from their caterpillar threads. All but one. A scrawny purple caterpillar sat near the others, but he paid his silly friends no attention as he gobbled down a leaf 3 times his size. His eyes and teeth were bright, but otherwise he was so dark and withered he looked like a charred piece of wood.
"Come on, Westley. I mean, Your Majesty," Sarah said.
She twirled and landed next to him with a plop.
"It's our last chance to play as caterpillars. Tomorrow, we'll all be delicate, like the rest of the butterfly grown-ups."
"Last chance is right," Westley said, wiping the corners of his mouth. Speaking loud enough so all could hear, he exclaimed, "It's our last chance to juice up before our change. Tomorrow, once our wings have taken shape in our cocoons, they'll be that way forever. That's why you should be eating with me instead of goofing off. Seriously, Sarah, you should sit next to me and have some of my angel ivy," suggested Westley, tearing off a piece. Sarah had a soft spot for her scrawny friend. She sighed.
"Yes, Your Highness."
She gave a half-hearted salute before grabbing some ivy. She opened her mouth to take a bite.
"Dirt eater,"
a classmate yelled, pointing at the empty air.
"Where?"
Sarah dropped her ivy and jumped to her feet. There was nothing to see, but the other caterpillars still formed a mock battalion. Assuming it was part of a game, Sarah played along. She gasped, putting her hands to her cheeks, and then called out,
"Intruders! Fire the sprinklers!"
And with that, she ran off with the other caterpillars.
"Hey! Hey, everyone!" Westley shouted after them.
When they didn't respond...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.